Hi there. Currently, there's a war in the world that everyone is talking about. But there is another, internet war, about which no one says anything. There is a small, private company that can control the entire internet. Let me explain to you better. Five small private companies control the internet of billions of people. Your access to the internet is in the hands of these five companies. They are Afrinic, Aaron, Apenic, Lacnic, and Ripe. They are the land registries for the internet's addresses. However, there aren't any more IP addresses for them to distribute because the IP address pool has been exhausted. Hence, this allows for the inevitable formation of the IPv4 market. These private companies are not supervised by any government, and because of the exponential increase of value in IPs, malicious people from these RIRs want to take advantage of their power to do things of their own will and for their interest. But what are our internet addresses? Now, let's dive into exactly what internet addresses are. Well, at this moment, you're watching this video, which means you must have an internet address. People call it an IP address. You need this IP address to visit the internet, get information, and be connected to the world. So, what are IPs? A technical definition of IP? IP stands for Internet Protocol, and it is what allows users to connect to the internet. Whenever a device accesses the internet, it is assigned a unique numerical IP address, such as 10.10.10.10. Every internet user has a unique IP address. That's pretty difficult to digest, isn't it? You can imagine IP addresses as your virtual home address. People send you letters and parcels to this virtual home address, and it is the home address that allows you to receive them properly. Without an address, you can't receive things from anyone. So, why are IP addresses essential for you? Because if you do not have an IP, there's nothing you can do with the internet, because the internet will not be able to send and receive anything. Now, here's the key question. Where and how did you get your IP address? Glad you asked. This may get confusing for many, so pay attention here. For people like you and me, we're called end users in the internet world. End user, as per the term, were the final users of the IP addresses. Many of us are not aware of the existence of IP because we automatically get them from our Wi-Fi provider or telecom when we purchase their services. Does this mean that Wi-Fi providers and telecoms manufacture IP addresses? No, they don't. They get the IPs from the regional internet registries, or RIRs. Yes, exactly. The five private companies. Aaron, Afrinic, Apenic, Lacnic, and Ripe. These five companies get their IP address from IANA. What is IANA? Internet Assigned Numbers Authority. It's responsible for delegating internet resources like IP addresses to RIRs. But what criteria does IANA use when they decide how many IP addresses they give to RIRs? The criteria of IP distribution is need-based. So if RIR shows IANA that they have this amount of need, IANA will give them the equivalent IP. And this repeats in all layers. RIR decides how many IPs they give to telecoms, depending on how many needs the telecom has. And how many needs the telecom has depends on how many needs they have from their customers. That's us, the end users. So theoretically, everything is supposed to be bottom-up, very need-demand of the end user base, and determines the supply of the IP address of the telecom, and the demand of telecom determines the supply of RIR, and so on. So, everything is fine and dandy, right? No, there's a huge problem. The world is more connected than at any other time in history. According to Statista, there are around 4.66 billion active internet users worldwide. That's over 50% of the global population. With more users going online now, IP addresses are exhausted, meaning that there aren't any more IPs left for the IANA to distribute. This is a huge concern, and it will leave millions all over the world without access to the internet. The demand for IPs grows exponentially every year, leading to a surge in the price of IP addresses. IPs have suddenly become a commodity that carries a commercial value today, and in total, it's valued at over $2 trillion worldwide. This naturally has led to the emergence of the IPv4 market, a commodity with a huge commercial value can only be distributed efficiently with the market. Since 2016, due to the global IP address shortage, many firms began to specialize in IP address management, such as cloud innovation. These firms delegate IP addresses to customers, such as global telecommunication companies and internet service providers. They support millions in their connectivity to the internet. For example, Cloud Innovation manages 6.2 million IP addresses, which means they give internet access to millions of end users. However, in 2020, Afrinic and its CEO, Eddie Mabano Caira, issued a hostile, malicious letter to Cloud Innovation, trying to force them into giving up IP addresses. Until now, they've failed to resolve this case despite peaceful efforts. In the letters sent to Cloud Innovation from Afrinic, Eddie has made claims that are concerning to the entire internet. Imagine walking down the street to your local store to purchase a SIM card. Harmless, right? No. Because according to Afrinic, the SIM card company must inform them of such a purchase. Eddie claimed to have the right to approve new customers of every internet service provider with the following clause. Every member should notify Afrinic of any change of usage in resources. This is false, as Afrinic doesn't wield such unilateral power as to stop our freedom of speech. This is an abuse of power and the spread of misinformation. Their second claim is having the right to limit the use of IP to 55 countries with the clause, Afrinic claims that they have the power to limit a member's service to within 55 countries. Again, Afrinic is abusing its power, claiming that once you're an Afrinic member and are using resources from them, you're not allowed to provide services outside of the 55 countries that they have specifically designated. Now picture this. The internet is a vast network and constantly growing and expanding. Imagine trying to access certain websites outside the 55 countries Afrinic has designated. Your IP can't do that. If you're in Africa and you want to access websites outside Africa, Afrinic can disconnect you anytime. Afrinic becomes an extremist and totalitarianist. By disconnecting the entire African continent from the rest of the world under Eddie's management, their corrupted action makes them no longer a part of our free world. The final claim made by Afrinic is even more ridiculous. Eddie claims that Afrinic has the right to monitor every end user and they force all their members, i.e. telecoms, to submit the data to them, or else Eddie threatens to destroy their business by disconnecting all their end users, which is you. Afrinic can know every website you have visited, sell your data without your acknowledgement, promote political propaganda, and take away your freedom of speech, making them the devil of the internet. All your internet activity will now be monitored by an OIR whose main job is to simply give you internet access. The best way to explain it is this way. Imagine buying an iPhone, but Apple tracks everything you use the phone for. That is a gross invasion of privacy and abuse of power. This is illegal and criminal. Remember, OIRs don't experience any oversight from anybody. To make things worse, Afrinic's end senior management, Ernest Byanga, he's caught with a shell company in Uganda. that actively stole 4 million IP addresses from other users, robbing them of their internet connection, he proceeded to sell these stolen IP addresses on the black market. Eddie became Afrinic CEO in 2019, and he promised to change the corrupt culture of Afrinic. However, he didn't fulfill his promise. He even started a new policy called assisted review as a means to reclaim IP addresses from the members. This poses a tremendous threat to members' business and endangers the stability of the entire internet, while Eddie can potentially gain huge profit by giving these reclaimed IPs to his personal relatives. Here is where cloud innovation is getting in, trying to protect our internet, militating for transparency and our fundamental freedom. The internet was the first invention ever created by humans that doesn't have geographical, gender, or racial differences. We should never change that. So, what can you do to help? Stand and support us in this fight against injustice so we can protect the internet and its freedom. How? You can do so by letting your local governments know that Afrinic is a corrupt organization and makes baseless claims. Spread the message and raise awareness of the issue. Share this video with your friends and talk about it online and through social media. It is time to spread the word that we shall never tolerate corruption and totalitarianism, because the internet is a place of freedom, and it will always be.